Hi, my name is Jeremy Sutton, and I'm going to be your guide to the Van Gogh brush pack, especially for your use in Corel Painter and in Painter Essentials. I'm originally from London. I used to live in the Netherlands, and there the name of the artist is pronounced Vincent van Gogh. Right behind me, you'll see my version of the Vincent van Gogh sunflowers. This was created as part of a tableau vivant performance at the De Young Museum here in San Francisco, in which I reenacted the role of Vincent van Gogh and created my version of his sunflowers. And these works were all originally worked on using Corel Painter, and I output them onto canvas. And then what you see in the performances here is actually adding acrylic paint to those canvas prints. Vincent van Gogh's flower paintings are predominantly from the period when he was about 36 years old, it's 1889, and he was in the south of France. Vincent van Gogh was born in 1853. And when we think of van Gogh's paintings, we think of these wonderful thick brush strokes, these very expressive, bold colors. But in fact, when Vincent started off learning to paint, he was in his late 20s. See that the early paintings of Vincent van Gogh actually have quite limited palettes, are really more tonal than full of vibrant colors. Now, he was very interested in color. In fact, he asked his brother to send him books on color theories, and he took quite an interest in the theories of Charles Blanc, identifying the effect of what are known as complementary colors from opposite sides of the color wheel, and how they create a vibrancy between them. And in later works of Vincent van Gogh, you'll actually notice the quite explicit and dramatic use of the juxtaposition of these complements of things like blue against orange, or the violets against yellow, and the reds against green. What really changed his artistic life dramatically was moving to Paris. That's when he was exposed to Delacroix's use of these vibrant complementary colors. He was also very influenced by the Pontalists, people like Georges Seurat, of using pure dabs of color juxtaposed next to each other. And here's a Vincent van Gogh painting, Bank of the Seine, from around 1887, in which you can clearly see the influence of the Pontalists. Here we have a painting by Vincent van Gogh in which you can see very clear use of these dabs of pure color. Vincent was very interested in color combinations, and he did studies and was really experimenting with the effect of complementary colors, etc. And if you go to the Vincent van Gogh Museum in Amsterdam in the Netherlands, you'll actually see this very box with examples of these balls of wool with color combinations, which you actually see him using in his painting. You can see here the juxtaposition of unmixed color, and you can see how after everything dried, he put his signature here. Little interesting aside, on one of my visits to this museum, the docent explained that Vincent reckoned that people outside the Netherlands wouldn't be able to pronounce van Gogh. And so even when he wasn't actually that well known, he decided, I'm going to write my name as Vincent because everybody can pronounce Vincent. And in the final years of his life, one of his subjects that he loved to paint was flowers. In this case, you see these beautiful irises. And of course, he's very well known for his
sunflowers, for which he's best known when it comes to his flower paintings. And that's the example that we're going to be following.